Hello students, welcome to my channel Learning History Made Easy. In today's video, I will be continuing with the chapter wise important question series. Today's video will be about chapter 4.4. Before going into the video, if anyone is seeing the channel for the first time or if you have not subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe and share it with your friends, and also click the bell button to receive notifications whenever I upload new videos. So without wasting time, let us get into today's video. Which was the original home of the Kushanas? China. Who was the greatest king of the Kushanas? Kanishka. Which was the capital of Kanishka? Purushapura. Now we will go on to an important 5 mark question. In this chapter there is no important 10 mark question. There are only 3 1 mark question and 1 5 mark question. So let us move on to the 5 mark question. Describe the chief characteristics of the Gandhara school of art. So let us see what all points have to be included when a question is asked about the characteristics of Gandhara school of art. So the question is characteristics of Gandhara school of art. Gandhara school of art. So when such a 5 mark question comes, let us see what all points are to be included. The main characteristics of Gandhara school of art, the first characteristics was life-size statue of Gautama Buddha. Life-size statue of Gautama Buddha. Gautama Buddha were carved in this school. And till then, Buddhist existence was shown in the form of symbols, that is lotus, umbrella, etc. But during the time of Gandhara school of art, life-size statues of Gautama Buddha was carved. The second characteristics, if you see, was utmost care was given to the symmetry of the body. When the statues were made, the symmetry of the body were carved with utmost care. Symmetry of the body were done with utmost care. And for example, the muscles, mustache, all were shown in natural settings. So that was the second characteristics, that is utmost care was given to the symmetry of the body and muscles and mustaches were shown in natural setting. The next characteristics, that is folds and turns of clothes, were exhibited with minute care and skill. The folds and turns of clothes. Folds and turns of clothes also were exhibited with minute care and skill. Minute care and skill. That was the third characteristics of Gandhara school of art. The next one, that is when it come to the carving of ornaments, ornaments were carved on the statues with much attention. Carved with attention. Okay, so the ornaments were carved on the statues with much attention, and this added to the physical beauty of the statue. The carving of the ornaments added to the physical beauty of the statue. So all the ornaments were carved with great attention, which increased the physical beauties of the statues. So next characteristics, that is the fifth characteristic, that is the statues were polished. Okay. Polished statues. Gandhara school of art, the statues were polished. Polished statues is an important feature of Gandhara school of art. The sixth characteristic, the main material. Now what were the materials used for making the statues? The main materials used for making the statues, that is stone, terracotta and clay. These were the three main materials which were used for making statues during this time. And final, the last point is the technique of making the statues was Greek, but the idea and inspiration and the personality were Indian. Okay, the technique of making the statues were Greek, but the idea, inspiration and personality were Indian. So it was a mix of Indo-Greek technique. Gandhara art was a mix of Indo-Greek style of art. So according, finally, as a conclusion, you can write, according to Dr. R.C. Mazumdar, according to Dr. R.C. Majumdar, the Gandhara artist, okay, the artist during the Gandhara time, Gandhara artist had the hand of a Greek and heart of an Indian, heart of an Indian. So that is the same thing which we have discussed in the seventh point, that is the technique was Greek, that is the artist had hand of a Greek, but the idea, inspiration and personality were of Indian, that is they had the heart of an Indian. So these were the important characteristics of Gandhara school of art. Now let us see the points once more, the important characteristics of Gandhara school of art. The chief characteristics of Gandhara school of art were: life-size statues of Gautama Buddha were carved in the school. Until then, Buddhist existence was shown in the form of symbols like lotus, umbrella, etc. Utmost care was given to the symmetry of the body while carving the statues. Muscles and mustaches were shown in a natural setting. The folds and turns of the clothes were exhibited with minute care and skill. The ornaments that were carved on the statues received much attention. This added to the physical beauty of the statue. Polishing the statue is an important feature of this art. The main material used for preparing the statues were stone, terracotta and clay. The technique used in making the statues was Greek, but the idea, inspiration and personality were Indian. According to Dr. R.C. Majumdar, the Gandhara artist had the hand of a Greek, but the heart of an Indian. So all these were the important questions from chapter 4.4. So I hope you have understood all the points very clearly. If you have any doubt, please do feel free to ask in the comment session. And also don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. Your likes and shares will be of a great encouragement for me to make more and more videos. So I hope to see you all soon in the coming video. Thank you for watching.